वालेकुम क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव आवर 10th लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 4 द ट्रांसपोर्ट इन प्लांट्स ऑफ ग्रेड 7 सब्जेक्ट साइंस. वाटर एंड डिसॉल्व मिनरल सॉल्ट्स फॉर्म द रूट्स मूव वेरी क्विकली थ्रू द जाइलम अप द स्टंप एंड लीव्स. द मेन फोर्स व्हिच ड्रॉज वाटर अप द प्लांट इज कॉज्ड बाय अ प्रोसेस कॉल्ड ट्रांसपिरेशन. Now water evaporates from the leaves and diffuses out of the tiny pores, the stomata, on the underside of the leaves. Up the stem, the transpiration pool. Transpiration is the loss of water from aerial parts of the plant, especially through stomata of the leaves. And what's the transpiration pool? Suction force caused by transpiration, main factor that causes water to move up the xylem. Now what's transpiration stream? Stream of water moving up. Now why is transpiration important? Draws water and mineral salts from the roots to the stems and the leaves. Evaporation of water from the cells in the leaves remove latent heat of vaporization, so the plant is cooled. Water transported to the leaves. The water that is transported to the leaves is used for photosynthesis and maintaining the turgidity, the rigidness, the hardness, stiffness of the leaf cell. Environmental factors that affect transpiration. Number one is temperature of air, air humidity, light intensity, wind or the air movement, and carbon dioxide concentration. These five factors can affect transpiration. So let's discuss one by one the factors that affect the transpiration. Number one is the temperature of air. Higher temperatures increases the rate of evaporation. The higher the temperature, the greater the rate of transpiration. If you see in the diagram, they have shown the temperature. Number two is air humidity. Air inside the leaf is saturated with the water vapors. Increasing the humidity of the air will decrease the water vapor concentration gradient between the leaf and the atmosphere, therefore decreasing the rate of transpiration. So how the rate of transpiration is decreasing? Because of increase in the humidity, the air, it will decrease the water vapor concentration between two factors, the leaf and the atmosphere. The lower the humidity, the faster the rate of transpiration. This is the transpiration and this is the humidity. The lower the humidity, the faster the transpiration process. Number three is light intensity. When light intensity is increases, guard cells become turgid, they become rigid, they become hard. The stomata opens, increasing the rate of transpiration. When light intensity is reduced, the stomata closes. So if the stomata closes, the light intensity will be reduced. And if the stomata opens, there will be an increase in the transpiration. In greater the light intensity, the greater the rate of transpiration. So the greater the light intensity, the greater the rate of transpiration. Number four is wind or air movement. Blows water vapors away at the surface of leaves. Increases concentration gradient between water vapors in the leaf and the outside of the leaf. This would increase transpiration. When the air is still, temperature reduces or it stops. If the air is still, not moving, transpiration reduces or either it just stops. The stronger the wind, the faster the rate of transpiration. As you can see, the stronger the wind, the faster the rate of transpiration. Five is the carbon dioxide concentration. When carbon dioxide concentration in the intracellular spaces of the leaf falls below the critical concentration, the stomata opens. This increases transpiration. As we have discussed in the previous one also, that stomata opens increase in the rate of transpiration. This increases transpiration, and increase in carbon dioxide concentration will decreases the rate of transpiration, and increase in the carbon dioxide concentration that decreases the rate of transpiration. The speed of transpiration varies with the condition of the plants and its surrounding. When the water is in short supply, when we don't have enough water, or if the roots of the plants are damaged, the plant slows down the rate of transpiration. So because of two factors, either the root of the plants, they are damaged, or either there is short supply of water, the plant slows down the rate of transpiration by wilting. If the rate of transpiration decreases the rate of water absorption, cells become flaccid and plants wilt. Now, what's the advantage? Obviously, there is an advantage and a disadvantage to wilt. Reduce rate of transpiration. If the rate of transpiration reduces, this will also reduces water loss, and the disadvantage is that stomata are closed, reducing entry of carbon dioxide. Rate of photosynthesis decreases. So that's a disadvantage. Rate of photosynthesis should not decrease in any case. Root pressure is the transverse or is the opposite of the osmotic pressure within the cells of a root system that causes sap to rise through a plant stem to the leaves. On a large tree, there may be countless thousands of leaves from which water is evaporating. As a result, water is pulled up the xylem vessels with a tremendous force. The force is big enough to draw water 50 meters or more up the trunk of big trees. Added to this, water is also pushed up by the stems. Water is also pushed up by the stems or trunk by a pressure acting on it from the root. This pressure is called root pressure. Transport of food in plants. Food substances such as sugars and amino acids are manufactured in the green leaves through the process called photosynthesis. Translocation is the process of transporting food substances downwards from the leaves to all other parts of the plant through the phloem. So the transport of gases need oxygen too. Plants obtain the gases they need through their leaves. They require oxygen for respiration and carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. In the light, in the presence of light, if you see in the diagram, in the daylight, when photosynthesis is faster than respiration, carbon dioxide diffuses in while oxygen diffuses out. Whereas in the light, carbon dioxide diffuses out where oxygen diffuses in. Epidermis of a leaf. These gases diffuse into the intracellular spaces of the leaf through pores, which are normally on the underside of the leaf, which is called the stomata. From these spaces, they will diffuse into the cells that requires them. Lenticels. Gases have to pass through small openings in the bark called lenticels. Lenticels are the pores in the bark of the stem, as you can see in the diagram as well. They have given a very nice example. If you are sitting in a room and someone comes in wearing perfume and sits at the other end, the smell of the perfume quickly fills the whole room. You will feel the perfume smell in the entire room. Molecules of the perfume or a vapor move about freely until they have spread out. So they will move freely, the molecules of the perfume, they move freely or they diffuse out evenly across the entire room. So they are saying that the same process of the diffusion is how gases move in and out of the plants. So they are giving you the example of how actually gases are moving in and out of the plant during respiration. During the process of respiration, oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is given out. So basically they are taking the oxygen inside and they are just releasing the carbon dioxide out. If we see in the daylight, when photosynthesis is faster than respiration, carbon dioxide will diffuse in. The carbon dioxide will diffuse in, whereas carbon dioxide has to be out. But during the daylight, carbon dioxide diffuses in while oxygen diffuses out. Similarly, in the leaves and the green stem of the plants, the gases enter and leave through the stomata. So likewise in the leaves and the green stem of the plants, gases will enter and leave through stomata. Then they diffuse between the air spaces between the cells to reach all parts of the stems that I have told earlier and shows you the diagram of the lenticels, which is the small openings in the bark. Root obtains their oxygen from the air spaces. So roots, they are obtaining their oxygen from the air spaces between the soil particles. In the soil particles, all the air spaces that are left behind, roots will take their oxygen from there. Most of this oxygen is dissolved in the soil water. So most of the oxygen that the roots are gaining, they will dissolve in the soil water that is present already, which enters the root through the growing region of the root hairs. So this is it for today's lecture and end of this chapter. I hope you get to know about how plants actually transport, how transportation takes place in the gases and the food, all of that. Any questions or queries related to this chapter or the previous one also, just feel free to message me, just feel free to ask. And yeah, that's it for this chapter. Now we're going to start our next chapter soon. Take care. Thank you so much.